Hello student, welcome back. Last class we saw depletion MOSFET. So let me recall the concept what we covered. In MOSFET there are two classification, enhancement MOSFET and depletion MOSFET. So once again under enhancement or depletion MOSFET you have either P channel or N channel. So last class we covered depletion MOSFET. So depletion MOSFET, one of the important properties of the depletion MOSFET is it works like an enhancement MOSFET or depletion MOSFET. Because in depletion MOSFET, there is already a channel exists between source and drain. So by controlling the gate voltage, I mean gate to source voltage in the positive direction, it acts like an enhancement MOSFET. Enhancement MOSFET, or by controlling the gate to source in the negative direction, it acts like a depletion. So it acts like a depletion. That is means a reduction in the current. Enhancement means a increase in the current. In today class, we will see E MOSFET, enhancement MOSFET. So the constructions of enhancement MOSFET once again same. This is called as N channel MOSFET. This is called as N channel MOSFET. And this is called as P-channel MOSFET. As explained earlier, it has got four terminals. First one is called a D-type, drain, gate and source. And the fourth one is called as a substrate. Here in N-channel, we are using P-type of substrate, which is connected to the drain terminal through ohmic contact. And N-type of dopant is connected to the source through ohmic contact, source of terminal to ohmic contact. But our gate is not connected to the P-type of substrate directly because there is a insulation in between. Because of this insulation, the input impedance of this one is very large. So now, in P channel, we have N type of substrate and other than a drain, gate and source. This is the architecture we offer P channel and N channel MOSFET. Please remember, in N channel, P type of substrate and P channel, N type of substrate we are using. So now, how the operation works? Before going to operation, dear students, we will see the symbol for N-channel MOSFET and P-channel MOSFET. The symbol for N-channel MOSFET and P-channel MOSFET. So, we have four terminals. One is gate, other one is a drain, then source, and the fourth terminal is a substrate. Now, you can see the dotted line between drain to source. So, this is the dotted line between drain to source indicates there is no direct electrical channel exists between drain and source. So, in case of depletion MOSFET, this line was solid line, but here it is a dotted line indicates there is no electrical contact. So, this is the this is P-channel type of E MOSFET. Now by using three terminal you can write like this. So this is the symbol for N channel and this is the symbol for P channel. So now how this works, the operation of the E channel E MOSFET, how this works. So initially we know in E channel MOSFET there is no channel between drain to source. So in order for the flow of current, first channels should exist to make the channel or to create the channel between drain and source. We need to give some amount of gate to source voltage. Initially gate to source voltage is zero. That means our MOSFET is under cutoff state. This is called as a cutoff state. Our MOSFET is under cutoff state because VGS is zero. There is no channel between a drain to source, and so there is no flow of a current between drain to source. Now, when you increase VGS, when you increase the value of VGS, that means when I increase this value of VGS, then there will be a channel will be created between drain to source. But when the channel created, will there is a current? So when you give VGS, when you increase the VGS, a channel will be created between drain to source. But now the question comes, is there a current in this case? No, because to flow the current between drain to source, we need to give potential difference between drain to source. Then only current will flow between drain to source. Now we will see the operation of this one, in the next slide, how this works. See here the operation of this one. This is N-channel MOSFET. N-channel MOSFET. So you can see here, this is the fourth terminal substrate. This is connected to the source, and gate is connected to the positive end of the battery. When I increase VGS, here, so the minority carriers in the substrate, that is electrons, will move towards, it will attract towards the gate, and here majority carriers, that is holes, moves towards the substrate. In this way, channel will be created between our drain to source. If you keep on increasing the gate to source voltage, channel depth will be more, and more current will flow. But the current will flow. But in order to the flow of current, we know we need to give the potential here also here. So this is VDS. Here you can see VDS, positive end is of this battery is connected to the N-type of material. That means here we are giving reverse bias. When you increase the reverse bias more and more, this channel will get depleted, and somewhere the ID current will get saturated, and after increasing in the VDS, that is called as pinch off voltage, after increasing the VDS, ID current remains constant. So constant, this we can see in the next slide. So here you can see, as we increase VDS, channel width will get depleted. You can see channel width will get depleted, and it will reach something called as pinch off condition, where current, small amount of current flows, or current will get saturated, and this condition is called as pinch off condition. So in the next slide we will see characteristics equation here. See, this is the characteristics equation for our this one N-channel MOSFET. So initially you can see, when VGS is there is zero, there is no current. When you increase the VGS, so you have to increase the VGS. At least a minimum amount of VGS should be given. That is called as threshold voltage. Till you increase the VGS greater than threshold voltage, there won't be a current. The MOSFET will be in the saturation region. When you increase VGS greater than threshold, MOSFET will work in the this one ohmic region, and it will move to the saturation region. Here you can see, when you give VGS 3 volt, this is somewhere here pinch off will occur, and this is the curve. When you give the VGS 4 volt, this will increase something like this. When you give the VGS 5, this will increase something like this. So if you increase VDS further, here initially the curve will in current will increase, but to certain extent after that it will get saturated. You can see here it will get saturated, but if you increase the VGS, the current also increases. You can see here in the case of depletion MOSFET, it can work either in the enhancement mode or it can work in the depletion mode. But in the enhancement MOSFET, it will work like this. So this is the character output characteristics, ID versus VDS. And we have one more that is called as transfer characteristics, ID versus VGS. You can see as you increase the VGS, output current will increase. But initially the MOSFET will be in the cutoff state. Why? Because there is no channel between, there is no channel. So why? There is no channel. See, once again, we'll clarify this one. See, initially there is no channel. So you can see here, initially there is no channel. When you give voltage VGS, when there will be channel will be created, but the VGS value should be greater than threshold voltage, then it will move into the ohmic region. Then the channel will be created here. You can see here, when you give VGS voltage more than threshold volt, then minority carriers in the substrate will move here and it will create the channel. And as you increase VDS, the current moves. As you increase, these electrons will get attracted towards this one positive terminal and current increases. And if you increase VGS further, current will get increased. That we have seen in our transfer characteristics and output characteristics. In this way, E-channel E-MOSFET works. So E-channel E-MOSFET, we have one important formula. So this is the important formula to find out. IDS and IDS and VDS. So here we have one more constant, K. K is nothing but transconductance. K is called as transconductance or process conductance. K is called as process conductance. This is depend on ID one, VGS one. When VGS is one, what is the value of ID one? Minus V threshold. Based on this, we will calculate K. Please remember, when VGS one, for some value of VGS one, ID one. This is not ID. This is not IDSS, ID1 for VGS1. So based on this, we will calculate ID. So now it's a student will see the difference between JFET and MOSFET. So JFET operates in depletion mode only, but MOSFET operate in both depletion mode and enhancement mode. We know depletion MOSFET operates in depletion and enhancement mode. Enhancement MOSFET operates in enhancement mode. Then input impedance is in JFET, input impedance is greater than 10 to the power 9, but in MOSFET, high input impedance. This is because insulation between gate and substrate, high input impedance. Then high drain resistance, here low drain resistance, large leakage current in case of JFET. In case of MOSFET, we don't have leakage current. Why? Gate, in case of MOSFET, the large leakage current, here there is small leakage current. Why? Because we know in case of MOSFET, there is gate is insulated from the channel or substrate. Gate is insulated, that's why it's a low small leakage current and not easy for construction. It is easy for constructions. This is the difference between JFET and MOSFET. So with this so we need to solve a couple of problems here. So for that we need some of the important equations. We have seen the important equation, square law. See, square law for JFET depletion type MOSFET, the ID is given by for JFET and depletion type MOSFET, ID is, we calculate ID by using IDSS 1 VGS VP by square. And for enhancement type MOSFET, ID is given by this equation where K is called as transconductance or process conductance. It depends on various parameter. We are not going into that one. So ID is calculated in this case by using this formula, and in this case by using this formula. So my dear students, with this we have completed now important concept like D MOSFET and E MOSFET. So now will proceed to biasing of the MOSFET. Between that, before that, difference between JFET and MOSFET also we have covered. So this is the difference between JFET and MOSFET. So I have already explained you what is the difference between JFET and MOSFET. Now next one is biasing of the MOSFET. So what do you mean by biasing? How the biasing works? What are the different types of biasing with respect to depletion MOSFET or with respect to enhancement MOSFET? And you will try to understand all these concepts with a couple of examples in the next class. Thank you.